Masih pun ada deg-degan
kamu yang menarik. Ada di mana saja berada, kembali lagi di acara Beranda UMKM. Hari ini spesial ya, kebetulan saya yang akan mengawal, Dahana Adi dari Culture Program Assistant Wisma Jerman yang akan mengawal acara ini dan juga berdialog bersama teman-teman untuk mencoba mencicipi kuliner-kuliner tradisional yang ada di sini. Ya, kebetulan karena saya sendiri perwakilan dari Pusat Kebudayaan Jerman di Surabaya, saya kebetulan juga mendapatkan kehormatan tamu nih dari Jerman juga. So, who has you?
My name is Daniel. I am from little bit in the middle.
Oh, nice. So, I know Bayern and I know Regensburg because my friends from Regensburg here. So, dan memperkenalkan yang lain. Kalau tadi mungkin snack dan juga nasi, kita beranjak ke minuman sedikit. We get a beverage, drink. This is traditional drink. Have you ever heard like this? Beras kencur.
Beras kencur?
Kencur, yeah. Beras rice, kencur is like a...
Ginger, aromatic ginger.
Yeah, I think like a kurkuma, like that.
My wife is fan from the ginger.
Wow, and kind of ginger.
I still not know, but I will happy try for you, no?
Yeah.
Red ginger and aromatic ginger and rice.
Yeah, but I think...
Waiting, I not feel fine and I will try.
Yeah,
of course.
Okay.
It is my medicine sometimes.
Yeah.
But I never know this brand.
Yeah, maybe we must introduce this kind of product, UMKM.
Yeah.
Do you know UMKM?
No.
UMKM not so really, really big, like footprint or like the brand, like KFC or something. But, this is from kind of like ordinary people who make food or beverage, it's come from order like that.
I like to try exotic food.
Yeah.
Very delicious, yeah.
But it's okay for your throat or stomach.
Oh, I like it. Maybe I have to buy it.
Yeah, okay. You must buy and try to make another herbal drink. Maybe it's not only to cut, maybe some kind of any ingredients. Maybe you can try to make a herbal drink in your home. And the next food is, of course, this. Of course, you know it. It's on Chinese food, of course.
Maybe I ever see. What is it? It is
dim sum.
Dim sum. What is the ingredients of dim sum?
Flour, with flour, and sometimes from shrimp, from chicken, or sometimes from meat.
From meat.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because this dim is one kind of my favorite food because I like bird food.
It is very soft.
Yeah.
And it is a good taste also.
It comes from shrimp and chicken. Yeah, shrimp and chicken, of course, it can be
soft taste.
Mm-hmm.
Delicious.
Sweet, a little sweet and
for the first time.
So this is your first time you eat dim sum.
Yes.
And you must try. This is from the tofu.
What is it tofu? I hope it is really good taste. But it is not. What is it?
Kuchen, of course.
Kuchen,
yeah,
yes.
Kuchen, of course.
The cake. I know the yellow rice and the egg, of course. Mm. I stay here since more than 3 years. And I did try a lot of this food, I think. Yeah.
Yeah. Do you know the name of this?
The yellow rice or?
The basically of this food, the tumpeng is made from yellow rice.
What means the name tumpeng?
Tumpeng. I don't know the exactly why it's called tumpeng, but the philosophy of tumpeng is we call it the thanks to God, ceremony or occasion, special occasion, especially for our life, for Japanese people, especially for Japanese people. Maybe after this, you make a tumpeng for your birthday girl.
For my baby.
Yeah.
And it is 1:24.
Yeah.
My wife is going to get a Caesar operation because it is more years old.
Maybe after that, maybe if your baby has 3 months or 1 year,
okay,
that and with the potato and chili, of course, because to make umami taste and
actually, I like it because it is a little bit spicy, the liver is smooth, and the kartoffel, the potato, it is smooth.
Yeah, kartoffel, cool. Yeah. And this is for noodles, of course.
The yellow noodles?
Yeah, yellow noodles. Yes. So, tumpeng is the symbol of diversity of any kind of culture. Like, noodles is come from China, of course. And that's a kind of diversity of, unity of diversity, I think. I mean. Okay, this is chicken, of course. Ah, this is also from, egg, scramble.
Frikadelle. Yeah. In Germany, the frikadelle is made from meat.
Oh, yes, that's a combination from meat and potato, of course. Yes, and beef. And potato, of course.
I only see potato at the moment.
Yeah, that's if we have extra price to offer something.
It is very smooth. Yeah. It is potato.
Yeah, because the potato is
mashed potato.
Yeah, mashed potato. And this is also an egg, but it fried with chili. We call it bumbu rujak.
Bumbu rujak?
Yes, rujak. It's not like rujak timur, but this is only a bumbu rujak.
Bumbu rujak? Egg?
Yeah.
Egg. It is duck egg or from the chicken?
No, chicken, of course. Because Japanese people sometimes doesn't eat duck egg. Food, maybe for the snack. Have you ever tried this? This is sometimes of if we go to Lebaran or Christmas.
Looks like in Germany we call it Passier. Cake, Sandkuchen?
Yeah, Sandkuchen.
Like a Passier cake?
Yeah, but in Indonesia we call it Lidah Kucing.
Lidah Kucing, because
kucing,
it's like
Lidah
Kucing.
We call it Lidah Kucing. That's a more sweet and tasty.
Sandkuchen.
More sweet then.
Yeah, I'm not much with this.